What about Distant Starlight? Hi, it's Calvin Smith here, and welcome to Creation Basics, where our goal is to make God's creation part of your everyday conversation. Today's question is about, what about Distant Starlight? Well, for those who believe in biblical creation, this brings up an interesting and perplexing question. Since a light year is a distance that light travels in a year, about 9.5 trillion kilometers, and the Bible indicates that the creation was only a little more than 6,000 years ago, how can we see stars that are much farther away than 6,000 light years? Well, the stars that we see with our naked eyes are within that range, so they shouldn't be a problem. However, even the unaided eye can see the Andromeda galaxy, which is 200 million light years away, for example. And with telescopes, we can see others way further away. And this is the light time travel problem. Even Big Bang believers have their own distant starlight problem, but we'll probably address that at another time. Now, creationists have proposed many solutions. One is that perhaps the speed of light has decreased since creation. Some people have interpreted slight variations in historical measurements of light speed as indication that light may have slowed. But they reason that if the speed of light were near infinite at the beginning, then light from all of the universe could have arrived on Earth on day 4, but the speed of light has decreased tremendously since then. However, almost all secular and creation astronomers agree that the data does not support this possibility. Furthermore, the speed of light depends on two fundamental constants that determine the structure of matter. If the speed of light changes, then everything else about the universe changes as well. That doesn't seem viable. Still, other creationists have proposed different ways the problem can be explained by the strange effects of general relativity, the modern theory that time is relative to space and gravity. The speed with which time passes depends on your location. In most cases, the differences are minuscule. But the proponents of this view argue that conditions were very different during creation week. Light could travel through much of the universe while only a day or so passed locally. And these are compelling proposals, but like all scientific models, also have some drawbacks. Perhaps we need to look at the problem differently from Adam's perspective. The stars we see today with the naked eye are not a problem because 6,000 years have passed and all the visible stars in the Milky Way are within the 6,000 year light years of Earth. But this would not have been the case for Adam. God created Adam 2 days after he made the stars. That means starlight had only 2 days to reach the Earth, but the closest star is more than 4 light years away. And we need to recognize that God used many processes during creation week that are way different than the process operating today. How did Adam see stars the first evening of his life? He must have seen them because otherwise stars could not have fulfilled their function to help humans mark time we read about in Genesis 1, 14 to 18. So even Adam had a light travel time problem. So perhaps we should attempt to solve Adam's problem, not ours. He didn't make Adam instantaneously out of nothing, but instead formed him from the dust of the ground. And God used a similar process to make the land and flying animals. And he caused the plants to grow rapidly out of the ground on day 3. In other words, God rapidly and miraculously matured many things during creation week. It seems both logical and theologically consistent that, in a similar manner, God could have rapidly matured the universe, bringing the light from distant objects to the earth in a way similar to trees instantly sprouting and rising to full height. In addition to creating the physical universe during creation week, God also created the laws that govern it. What if these laws were not in full effect until the end of that week, as we see when God created mature plants, land animals, and the first two humans? Instead of bringing starlight to Earth according to physical laws, God could have miraculously solved the light time travel problem on day 4 before putting the laws that govern light travel into effect. After all, nearly everything else about the creation week was miraculous. So what about distant starlight? Well, creationists have proposed several robust scientific solutions to the question, so there's no need to feel as if the question overturns the plain reading of the Bible. Hey folks, Calvin here. Subscribe to the channel, ring the bell, share the content, click the button, blah, blah, blah. I know, you've heard it so often, it's just annoying. But here's the thing. If you're enjoying this content and want other people to benefit from it as well, kind of think of it as donating to our Answers in Genesis Canada advertising campaign without having to spend a dime. We want to be good stewards of your support. And of course, advertising is very expensive. But with the algorithms set up the way they are, it's kind of like getting these platforms that are often quite unfriendly to Christian content to promote gospel outreach for free. And if you've been blessed by this content, understand the importance of biblical authority, and have the means, please consider giving a one-time gift or becoming one of our monthly supporters by clicking the link below. Stay blessed.